How did you first get involved with the Salvation Army?
In the fall of 2006, I decided I wanted to do something to help the Salvation Army. Bell ringing seemed to be the best thing to do. So I contacted them at the Salvation Army, and they were glad to have me join up with them as a bell ringer. And I was to go back at a few days before Thanksgiving and touch base with them again. And on the way to my lodge meeting, the Salute Masonic Lodge, it occurred to me that might make a good lodge project. So I presented it that night, and several of the guys spoke right up and said they'd be more than willing to help. I said, yeah, let's do it. So that year, I went up to City Hall, made sure everything was all right with them. Then when I come out of City Hall, I went to the store there, Charlie Ward's store, and touched base with Charlie about setting up there at his store. But Charlie was just full of enthusiasm. He said, absolutely. He said, as a matter of fact, you can set that bell up right in the front door if you want to. Well, of course, we didn't do that. But we did set up there, and Charlie couldn't have been more gracious. His wife offered to bring us out coffee from the grill and so forth, his wife Judy. And anyway, we had a good year. It was a good experience for us. So then last year, and now this year, we moved. We're down at Mr. Robert Pace's M.A. Pace store there in Salute. And we think of him as our host now. And that's how it kind of got started. And it's been quite an experience.
What are some of the most memorable stories that you have ringing the bell?
I could tell you hundreds of stories. I remember going home that first night and telling my wife, let me tell you what happened. And I told her story after story about the people I met. And I had this crazy idea, you know, I should write a book. Well, about 10 minutes later, that idea went away because I realized every bell ringer can tell the same story that I tell. But I guess the most memorable story that will always be with me was the little girl and her mother who came down the street last year. And the little girl was autistic. And her mother gave her the money to put into the kettle. It was a chore, but she finally got it in there. And after she did, I knelt down and gave her the biggest thank you I could muster. And then wished her a very Merry Christmas. But she was a little bit shy, so she kind of backed away, and her mother went on down the street. A little while later, they came back, and that little girl kept glancing over my direction. And when she did, and when they got close enough, I started waving to her, and I thanked her again. And she smiled the biggest smile that a child can give, and then she began to wave back at me. And Jessica, I will always remember that beautiful little smile she gave me, or that beautiful smile that little girl gave me, because I knew right at that moment I'd been blessed with a new friend. And that's just one of, story after story that not only myself, but any bell ringer could tell you.
Salute is a very small community. Mm-hmm. How do bell ringers kind of play a part in that community?
Well, from the very beginning, we realized that Salute, of course, is a little tourist town now. All the shops and the restaurants and so forth draw a lot of visitors, but they tend to draw the visitors on Fridays and Saturdays. Sundays also, but the Salvation Army doesn't ring bells on Sunday. So we only go Fridays and Saturdays. And, well, I don't know what to say. It's a small community. Things are quiet in Salute the first of the week. Such as today, for example, there wouldn't be too many, very few visitors visiting them. Come Friday and Saturday, it'll be different. Mm-hmm.